advance between you. Love one another, but make not a bond of love. Let it rather be a moving sea between the shores of your souls. Fill each other's cup, but drink not from one cup. Give one another of your bread, but eat not from the same loaf. Sing and dance together and be joyous, but let each of you be alone, even as the strings of a lute are alone, though they quiver with the same music. Give your hearts, but not into each other's keeping, for only the hand of life can contain your hearts. And stand together, yet not too near together, for the pillars of the temple stand apart, and the oak tree and the cypress grow not in each other's shadow. Kathy and Sam, in consonance with Gibran's sentiment, would you now drink to one another? Fill each other's cup, but drink from your own. Let this act symbolize your promise to one another to be yourselves and to risk what you are for the sake of what you can yet be. Let the drinking of wine remind you that what matters most in life is the spirit, not the letter, the wine, not the cup. The future is forever in the making, so do not cling too long to any present, however satisfying, lest it become an anchor, and therefore a dead past, rather than a springboard, and therefore a usable past. Sam, what pledge do you offer in token of these vows?
I offer this ring.
Kathy, what pledge do you offer in token of these vows?
This ring.
These rings are symbolic of the vows here taken. A circle is never ending, as should love be. These rings mark the continuation of a long journey together, to be filled with wonder, joy, surprise, victories, defeat, laughter, and grief. May these rings always remind their wearers of the outpouring of love on this, their wedding day. Sam, please place this ring on Kathy's finger. Do you, Sam, promise that from this day onward, she will be your wife, and you will stand with her in sickness and in good health, in joy and in sorrow? And do you pledge to her your respect and your love?
I do.
Kathy, please place this ring on Sam's finger. Do you, Kathy, promise that from this day onward, he will be your husband, and you will stand with him in sickness and in good health, in joy and in sorrow? And do you pledge to him your respect and your love?
I do.
And so, Kathy and Sam, in expressing your vows and your exchanging of rings, you have pronounced yourselves husband and wife, and you may now kiss one another.
Oh, boy.
Oh, my God.
inches tall. It's going to be great.
Yeah, thank you.
Everybody look up here for one second. Yes, and then
where are we supposed to write?
Right here, great! Thank you.
At the Green Room?
So you can say San Francisco War Memorial Green Room.
Yeah.
pretend like I'm not here. Act natural.
We're acting very natural.
Yeah. Very fluid at this point.
Just one more, Sammy.
I don't know what the disaster is.
Just one more.
I'll get on the other side.
Here's my aunt.
Sammy.
I'm sorry.
That was Brian. And
everyone's eating their wrong food.
The minister.
They're eating the wrong food. That's a problem.
We ate them. We've been eating everything, Kathy.
Thank you.
is right by the railway station. Right at this moment, there's a bomb scare going on in town. So this is why this place seems to be a little bit congested. Changing of the guard. We're about to run up the big hill and leave Cathy behind.
Alright, here we are, we're after the guards.
Here we are,
Sam, you're
after
the race
up the hill in downtown Windsor Castle.
Yeah.
Just sort of changing his guards. I think they were the Scots guards, were they?
Okay, where'd they go, Sam?
They went this way over here.
This way?
Yeah.
Where?
I'm not sure what they were doing, whether they were changing the guards or they've just been relieved. Whatever they were doing, they were in a hurry, so I had to run up the hill and catch you. And I ran to catch him, but I couldn't catch him because I'm older than Sam. So I got fed up halfway along. I can see this any day. There's a Land Rover coming, Sam, and you're filming it.
Yeah. No, I can't wait.
I don't know which way to go. Yeah, right, I'm on the wrong side. I should be over there. Well, he was coming down that side.
Yeah.
Must be Americans.
I think we should get the
sidewalk. Place is full of them. Probably from Idaho. Person.
Ridgeway?
No, now, what do you consider yourself?
That's a good shot of a standard.
So to me, the speed is disturbed by a lot of planes.
Yep. Well, she doesn't need some sun as well.
What is she doing here now?
Going around and saying,
well, just want to find out.
Somebody does this table.
Just go straight in.
Is that one of those new rifles?
Yeah.
Is he ready to use it?
It's one of those new rifles. There's always plenty of people here.
This is a slanted house, followed by the smallest street recorded in Great Britain. This is in Winchester.
Come on, Sam. Come here.
Last year this river was flooded.
Here we are in Eton, a very famous town with a very famous public school.
What are you doing?
Eton.
Let's take a little tour.
Now we're here at Eton School. Very famous park going to the Eton Chapel, which is a very established building in the Eton school system.
Yeah, we were just saying that Sam is a graduate
of Eton College. Why? Because he showed us that he's always Eton. Here we are in the courtyard of Eton Chapel. This is the main tower. When there's a gate, here goes Cathy.
Oh,
There's a statue in the middle there. I'm not sure who he is, but we'll go over there later. This is another dormitory, I believe, for the boys of Eton.
Is it on?
Yeah, it's on now.
Is it?
All right, Dad. So
everybody's talking.
Let's get a film.
All right, you got to say something.
It's horrible.
All right, I'll get you another one.
Oh, sorry.
I got you in now. Okay.
Okay.
And Kathy.
I'm not
going to
Sorry,
sir.
Okay.
Right, action. Take one.
Actually, all right.
Hello.
Okay.
Well, here we are.
Hey, Kathy, get over there, look.